Hey guys, I've been researching a problem I've got with my American Standard shower valve, and I've seen a lot of people with the same problem. So the problem is, when you get your shower up to temperature where you want it, then it starts water hammer and it won't stop. So this is the problem. My temperature is about right here. So as you can see, that ain't gonna work. And even if you slowly turn this on and bring this water up to temperature and then turn this back again, it ain't gonna work. So when I first put the shower in, that's what I had to deal with, and I was freaked out because this thing was all new, and I thought I'd just tear the wall back out. But I called American Standard. They were real nice, and the rep asked me if I had an older house, and of course I do. This house was built in 49, and they told me that these older houses have uneven pressures, and these anti-scald valves don't like that. So not to worry, they'd send me a new cartridge, and of course it came quick, free of charge. Appreciate that. But it only got us through. We still had to jump through hoops to take a shower. If you got this up to temperature, all the way hot, and slowly turned it back to where you liked it would stay as long as no one in the house flushed a toilet or turned a sink off or on. Or when you was in the shower, you better hope the ice maker didn't call for water, because when it shut off, it would start water hammering. So it was really embarrassing when we had company or somebody staying over for several days, because you had to bring them in here, give them this big old long lesson on how to operate the shower valve. So even this older valve now has started to, it's gotten to where it's like the original valve. So I set out to figure out, how can we stop this valve from trying to regulate that uneven water pressure? So I've been trying some experiments, and I finally figured it out. So what I'm going to do is show you guys exactly how to fix that water hammer on your American Standard valves. And I'm gonna start even from taking this whole thing apart. For people that have never even been in that thing, you'll be able to take this apart and fix it yourself. And for those that know how to get their cartridge out, then you can just skip ahead. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing I did, obviously, was shut the water off to the house, but I didn't film that because every house is different. I don't know how you shut your water off, but this is just a decorative cap right here on the end. It's just held in by an O-ring, so you just kind of carefully pop that out so that you don't scratch it like I almost did, but the shower valve's old and beat up, and I've had this part 100 times experimenting with all these different things I wanted to try. Inside is a Phillips screw, so we'll take that out. Now the handle on mine was stuck. Yours may not be stuck, it may be stuck, but if it is stuck, I don't recommend yanking and pulling and tugging and prying. Because if you pry, you'll bend this cover. If you yank on it, there's no telling what might break. So Home Depot or Lowe's, they sell an inexpensive handle pulling tool. So mine was stuck. I ended up making something in the shop, and then I realized I owned one of them handle pullers after I did all that trouble. But mine should hopefully come back off. Okay, so it's already getting tight again. So this piece just comes, first we're gonna take the cover off, because that piece will not come off. So these are held on with little plastic tabs, so be careful or they'll break. Pop that out. And then you have your two more Phillips. Thank you. long-winded Phillips. And then this is just a decorative cover, slide it off, and you'll now see your valve body. Okay, so in there we have four Phillips, and then we're going to pull this off, and inside this is the part that's giving you all your grief. So let's get this open. I would be careful here. You don't want to drop one of them screws down in the wall. Probably easily replaced, but I don't feel like hunting down a screw to fit this thing. Okay, so we got this out. It's probably good to put something over the drain too, just in case you drop a part. So the cartridge is inside. This is the part we're going to work on. It can be a little tight. It is held in by an O-ring. But I've had mine out so many times trying to figure out how to modify this thing that it comes out pretty easy. So let's get this on the table and I'll show you how I fixed mine. Okay, with your cartridge out, where we want to get is inside these caps. Now your cartridge may have the white caps. This is the one that American Standard sent me the second time that kind of worked. And maybe if they sent you one of these, if your house don't have extreme pressure differences like mine, this valve or cartridge, it might actually fix your problems. But I don't even know if they would still send these for free, but we can modify this and get rid of the water hammer. And like I said, your cap may be white and it may be black, but these are all, the guts are the same except for a few things. So you take a little screwdriver. This is held in by an O-ring. It's no big deal. You just want to pry it out carefully. And then in here, that little black O-ring right here is the culprit. Because this piece of plastic sticking out is attached to a diaphragm that goes down the middle that divides hot from cold, and the diaphragm moves left to right. Well, what I finally figured out, when it moves all the way, it basically, this O-ring stops the flow of water completely, I guess. I'm no expert on this. All I know is I took that O-ring off on both sides and it solved my problem. So basically what you can do is get a dental pick, or I mean, they're gonna, when I took mine off, it broke the O-ring. So this is like a one-way street. So once you do this, it's gonna tear up the O-ring, and if something happens, you need to put it back, you probably have to get some O-rings. But you basically can pry this up, and you can take an X-Acto knife and cut that O-ring off, or you can get a dental pick if you got one and just pry it and slide it over this, and then do it for the other side. Once the O-rings are out, you can put this back together. And that's really all you have to take apart on this. If you do have trouble getting the O-rings out, this is pretty straightforward. Four screws, and then this faceplate will come off. And this will open in the middle. But remember, the O-rings are what's holding these two halves together, so you have to pull hard. Then you can take the O-rings out. And you can see that diaphragm if you want to see what it looks like. One other thing I did, and I don't think it mattered, it was one of the experiments I tried earlier, was I pull these ports out, and they just pop right out. And inside these are the backflow preventers. And I basically took them out in one of my earlier experiments, thinking they were stopping, or I didn't know. I was trying everything. I was desperate. But I put it back together, and that didn't change anything. So this valve doesn't have its backflow preventers. And I'm not going to take my O-rings out because I'm just going to save this. The one that is in the shower now was the original one that came with the shower valve, and it's the one I took the O-rings off of. Because without those O-rings, it really can't try to regulate water pressure, because those O-rings stop the flow, and without them, the water can just be like an older valve. But a word of caution, I do believe by doing this, you're defeating your anti-scald properties of this cartridge. So if you got kids, it's something to consider. All I know is I wanted the freaking water hammer gone. It was driving me nuts. Couldn't even take a shower at the temperature we wanted. And we don't have kids. Don't have to worry about getting scalded. So that didn't bother me. So we'll go back in there, and I'll show you now that the shower works, because I've already put the altered valve or cartridge back in and put it back together. When you're finished, you just put this back in reverse order. And if you forget which way this went, well, American Standard labeled it for you. It says down right here, so you'll know which way that goes. Get all that back together, and I think your problems will be solved. Okay, so with everything back together, we can now even turn this straight to the temperature we want fast without it even water hammering. So you can just go to hot, let it get hot, turn it back to the temperature I want, anywhere in there. No more water hammer. We used to not be able to do that. If you turn this valve fast, you would always get water hammer, no matter what. So I'm pretty sure we've solved this problem. Now, before I post this video, I'll probably take a few showers and just make sure, because it's possible that by this valve not regulating, that our comfort zone may actually change now because it's not mixing the same as it used to. But if you see this video online, then obviously this all worked out for me. So thanks for watching. I hope this solves your problem. I did try water hammer arrestors. That didn't work. I tried bleeding the air out of the lines. Of course, that didn't work. Nothing really worked, except now that I've taken those O-rings out, it looks like we've solved the problem. So hopefully it will help you. And thanks for watching.